make leadership very, very accessible. And I believe in that. And not only do we want to make leadership more accessible, we want to make innovative followership more desirable than leadership, you know. Of the academy was simple to us, really. Our idea was to unleash and highlight the beauty that already exists in the community of Chisomo, you know, because we don't get to bring beauty to anything. All we get to do is to say, what is it that already exists in this community that maybe the people may not necessarily fully understand the beauty of? And to us in Chisomo, soccer was that. And so we started out on this, you know, on this experimental program, on this experimental project that is evolving into an academy, into a soccer academy today. Begin to think, you know, okay, Ningabangire, raise why you live. Put my game, you can change. Is there a chance that you could come in and open doors to her?
I'm so excited to have the Scholar Athlete Program, which is the program which is bringing the athletes which we're dealing with, but they're so underprivileged in that community, to take them back to school, to try to help them, to give them a means to get back to school as tuition. So I'm most excited with that program because it's a program that will actually sustain the living of the community, not only to the family of that child, but the whole community as a whole.
Thanks a lot.
Thanks
a lot.
Okay.
And time and time again, I'm feeling incompetent, cause my woman back home, we constantly arguing.
Hi, I'm Melissa, and I'm very excited to have the first women's Malawian soccer team underneath the Chisomo Idea movement. For me, back in 2008, when we took a trip over to Malawi and we ran clinics for kids, I got an opportunity to play with the women over there in the local communities, and I think that was one of the best experiences I've had in Malawi, and also the most personal to me. My desire and hope for the women's soccer team is that this will be a place of encouragement to them, a community of encouragement and development, not only as a soccer player, but also as a person. I hope this is the beginning of the team, the women's team, discovering purpose within themselves, within the community, and even serving others around them.
She can't afford and too educated to blame the corporate world. She got on welfare and hated it, caseworker, power tripping, and generally being degrading. If nothing else, she was treated sick and ineffective, which is the worst thing that she been left with.
Probably the greatest pieces of legacy we could leave behind would be to have no legacy at all. Because the point is that people within the communities we work in would, at the very end of the day, at the very end of what whatever we do, would be for them to look back and say, look at what we did. So because we are and we've always been a team of misfits, right? A team of individuals from whom nothing too much was ever expected. And so we kind of want to leave it that way. And I think that often in the non-profit paradigm is, hey, here is what we are doing in this particular community and we need your help, we need you to help us out. And we just thought that that has been overplayed. And with that, we just actually, to be honest, we think that that is actually not very helpful. So our idea wasn't, here's what we're doing, come help us out. The idea was to create something that we are proud of, so that when people look from the outside, they say, this is something I want to be a part of. You know, and that is the point, and that is the key. Because whatever we're building, we want it to be not only empowering, another word that's also being overplayed, but also sustainable. We want this to be something that runs, and that runs for a really, really long time. And if we can create something so compelling that we want to be a part of it ourselves, then what's the point of doing it?